Friends, howdy doody. It is Monday in the market, and we live in the upside down world right now of the stock market, and we're going to explain why, but I'm sure there's a lot of people that are very confused about what's going on right now with SoFi, because when a company reports good earnings, generally the stock should go up, but this is not the regular market. Let's talk about what's going on here, friends. Hey, hope you are well. So this is a situation where we have a company that is reporting good earnings, SoFi here. Going to those here in a little bit, in a minute. And then, you know, you have SoFi who's reporting good earnings, but the stock is being demolished. And what little bit we got up, it has been sold off at this point, but I don't think it's all terrible. And then you have Tesla who's reported terrible earnings. And not only that, Tesla said, hey, if you like that, just wait to the next quarterlies. They're probably going to be worse. By the way, the ones after that, the rest of the year, they're going to be really bad. And then maybe even next year. By the way, we're revamping the whole company. And people argue, they get mad for a while, and then Tesla says some more things, and now the stock starts to go berserk again because people have FOMO with it. So this is just the situation with the market right now. And if anybody's new to the market, when you try to explain things to them like this, you know, they go, oh, this doesn't make any sense. You know, I thought you wanted your companies to have good earnings. You do. But, you know, popularity in the stock market is a really big thing too. So let's get into this. So SoFi just released earnings. They beat earnings. They weren't the earnings that analysts were wanting them to have, in the sense of, like, you know, they weren't insane, but they were good. They were good. I'm going to put all this up here. And with that too, we're just seeing SoFi still, you know, I said this two months ago. SoFi is in a situation right now where it's being held up by the general market, and it's being held up by, you know, where the economy is. I honest to God believe that, because you're not seeing big consumers buy into it right now, big banks, big investment groups. You know, you're not seeing this because people don't know where the economy is going. They don't know where we're gonna be at war tomorrow. Like, they just, like, and when you're investing in bank companies, you're investing in companies that are strictly living off, like, the banks are the front line of the market. If the market goes bad, it's because the banks have went bad, and or it's vice versa. Like, it's just, that's just what it is. So right now you have SoFi, a company that is projected within the next 5 to 10 years to be a huge company. They all have almost 9 million users. That's huge. And they're all making bank accounts, savings accounts, they're taking loans, they're doing student loans, they're doing all that kind of stuff, car loans, house loans, you name it. But then you have just this uncertainty, this situation where people are not trusting SoFi enough to where the stock can even hit a measly $10 and keep it right now. It cannot get up to even $9 and sustain it. So with that, let's talk about these quarterlies and what happened. You know, with the chart here, we saw sell off. You know, SoFi didn't even make it to $8 during actual market hours. We saw $8, like, I think it was like 8:15, some change, after hours before market. But still, massive sell-off once these earnings came out, because this is what happened. The earnings supplements noted that new member additions in the quarter stood at 622 million, up 44%, year over year. SoFi now has more than 8.1 million members. So that is growing, and by next year, that is expected to be a lot bigger. 16% year over year during the first quarter to 21.16 billion. And for the second quarter, SoFi models adjusted net revenue of 55 million to 565 million. Well, analysts were looking for 581 million. The company also anticipates 150 million to 125 million in adjusted earnings before interest. So these are kind of some of the bare numbers that have come out here with SoFi. So it wasn't terrible. Like I said, you know, they beat quarterlies for God's sakes. I mean, I think that's the main thing. But like anything else, we have a market right now. And you know, you can be listening to, there's so many different people right now on where the market's at. And there's certain people that I like to listen to, and there's certain people that I listen to, but I don't know that I believe them. And, you know, Tom Lee is one of these investors that I like listening to, just simply where his head's at and what he is predicting here. And he's kind of back and forth right now where he thinks the market's at. But, you know, this is, like I said, this is a situation where SoFi is just, it's like, it's in a corner, and it's just like, it's like a bull waiting to be left out, let loose here. I really think that. I think SoFi is waiting for two situations to happen right now. I think it's waiting for one, a bull market. I think we're seeing this across the board, where we're seeing these companies that are reporting great quarterlies, great growth for the next few years, that we know they're going to keep doing great, but their stock is still down. It's not even a double digit stock, and SoFi falls right into that category. Second, SoFi is simply just waiting for some kind of deal, something to happen, for some big investor to walk in here and say, hey, we as an investment firm, we're going to buy 500 million shares, 500,000, whatever X number it be, of SoFi. We believe it's going to, they put a projection on it. We believe it's going to be, you know, X this price by, you know, maybe even X this date. That could possibly happen. And we saw a little bit of that. And that's how kind of, you know, Palantir got in. I don't want to say SoFi and Palantir are the same company, because I know they're not. Two different things here. But they are very similar of what's going on here, I think, and possibly could happen. You know, SoFi, Palantir sat at $7 to $6, $8 on a good day for a long time. And it got to a point where people were like, is this, like, we know this company is worth more. They're reporting good quarterlies. Their growth the next 5 years is solid. And they keep having deals. Well, it just, one day, you know, Palantir came through with a big old deal, and then that got the ball rolling, and then they got another one. Then, you know, all these analysts are paying attention to them, and then all these investors are paying attention to them, and now SoFi is well over $20 stock, and probably this time next year it'll be a $40 to $50 stock. That's probably just what's going to happen. So SoFi has got very similar things going on right now with Palantir, where it's just, it's waiting for its moment. It is waiting for its moment. It's on the sidelines, like, I'm just waiting. But I think buying it up right now at $6, $7, $8 is the smartest thing probably anybody can do for a long-term investment. You know, personally, what my hopes are for SoFi, when people ask me, like, what do you even want from SoFi as an investor? What I want is SoFi to obviously continue to grow, to be a very huge competitor in the banking system and where they're going with that. And obviously for the stock itself, yes, I want SoFi within the next 3 to 5 years to be a $50 stock minimum. And obviously later on down the road, if not then, we start talking about dividends. And hopefully by then, for us that are buying it, you know, or have already made a lump payment on it, buying into it, we have a ton of shares, and those ton of shares we start getting paid for off of dividends. So these are situations that could unfold with SoFi. So friends, here's what I'll say. You know, personally, I'm happy that SoFi had a great earning. I'm sad, and I'm disappointed that it's just where it's at. I still believe SoFi is going to do just fine. And honestly, if SoFi continues to take damage here, I'm still buying it. I'm almost, you know, in a selfish way, I'm happy that it's this price, because it means personally you get to keep buying it. I really think this is a situation where people are going to wake up one day and they're going to go, man, I should have bought more. And this is what we're watching right now with SoFi. So all in all, friends, I will talk to you soon. Everyone take care. Congratulations. I'm excited. I'm excited about SoFi. I really am. Friends, I'll talk to you soon. Bye, everyone.